हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, फ्रॉम हीट एंड थर्मोडायनेमिक्स टॉपिक, दिस इज अगेन अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन एंड यूजफुल फॉर जेई मेन स्पेशली. द टॉपिक इज मीन फ्री पाथ एंड कोलिजन फ्रीक्वेंसी. मीन फ्री पाथ एंड कोलिजन फ्रीक्वेंसी एंड दिस क्वेश्चन इज हाउ डज मीन फ्री पाथ एंड द नंबर ऑफ कोलिजन्स ऑफ ईच मॉलिक्यूल पर सेकेंड, राइट? हाउ डू द मीन फ्री पाथ and the number of collision of each molecule per second depend on the process, and the process specified is the adiabatic process. The process is specified, it is adiabatic, and we have to find out how does this quantity depend on volume, pressure and temperature. So this is very simple question, a very simple question, but a probable question for JEE Main. You can say it is a probable question for JEE Main 2020 or other exams also. The concept behind this question is simple, that the mean free path, which is denoted by lambda, which you call it mean free path, that mean free path denoted by lambda is equals to 1 over square root of 2 pi d square times n, where d is the diameter of gas molecule. Small d you can call diameter of gas molecule. This is the diameter of molecule, and a small n we define as the number of molecules per unit volume, that is molecular concentration, number of molecules per unit volume, right? So if it is number of molecules per unit volume, then this n can be replaced by total number of molecule. You can replace it total number of molecule and divided by volume capital V. And if you replace it total number of molecule divided by the volume V, and if you take this number of molecule per unit volume in this expression, you will know that lambda is now proportional to capital V, which is the volume. So from examination point of view, you have to learn this equation, that the mean free path is proportional to volume, whereas the collision frequency, if we talk of collision frequency, what is the collision frequency? So if you talk of collision frequency, then the collision frequency is given by V over lambda. That's the collision frequency, where V is the average speed. V is defined as the average speed divided by lambda. We are not going to simplify this expression, but we can simply know one thing, that the collision frequency F is proportional to, we all know that the average speed of gas molecule is proportional to square root of temperature. So it is proportional to square root of temperature. And on the bottom side, lambda, which is proportional to V. And that means the collision frequency is always proportional to square root of temperature divided by volume. So this is collision frequency, which depends on square root of temperature divided by volume, whereas mean free path lambda depends on volume. So these two are the concept for this question. Now we are talking of the adiabatic process, and that is for diatomic gas molecule. So if we talk of adiabatic process and for diatomic gas molecule, we have to find how does lambda and frequency depends on the volume. So part A. Part A, lambda is obviously proportional to volume. But now I want to know how does this frequency depends on volume. That's my question. How does this frequency depends on volume? That means you have to eliminate temperature. So frequency, which is proportional to root T upon V, right? And for adiabatic process, since the process is adiabatic, you can write one equation. You can write that equation, that temperature and volume to the power gamma minus 1 is constant value for the adiabatic process. And gamma in this case will be, we are dealing with diatomic gas molecule. So if we are dealing with a diatomic gas molecule, gamma for diatomic gas molecule will be 7 upon 5. So this is t and v raised to the power. You will put 7 upon 5 here. Gamma equals to 7 upon 5. So you will get t v raised to the power 2 by 5 as constant, which means t is proportional to v raised to the power minus 2 by 5. So you replace this t in this expression, which is proportional to v raised to the power minus 2 by 5. And then I get frequency proportional to numerator, which is square root of t. So square root of t will be proportional to v raised to the power minus 1 by 5 on the bottom v. And that means that frequency is proportional to v raised to the power minus 6 over 5. So that is A part. B part, how does this quantity depends on the pressure? Well, adiabatic process, we know that pressure P and volume raised to the power gamma, which is 7 by 5 in case of diatomic, is constant. So that means volume is proportional to P raised to the power minus 5 over 7. That the volume, which is proportional to P raised to the power minus 5 by 7. And since lambda is proportional to V, this lambda proportional to V, you will say that lambda is proportional to pressure P raised to the power minus 5 by 7. And about frequency now, for this frequency, since F in the previous expression is proportional to V raised to the power minus 6 upon 5, and V is proportional to P raised to the power minus 5 by 7. So you will replace this V here, and then frequency will be proportional to V, which in turn is proportional to P raised to the power minus 5 by 7, and this whole to the power minus 6 by 5. It implies frequency is proportional to P raised to the power 6 over 7. So now this is second part. Coming to the third part now. Third part, like dependency on the temperature. So I will use the same result here. Look, T and T into V raised to the power 2 by 5 is constant. So from here you can write that, V, if T is proportional to V raised to the power minus 2 by 5, then obviously when T proportional to V raised to the power minus 2 by 5, you can say that V is proportional to, right, minus of 5 by 2 of temperature, T raised to the power minus 5 by 2. Right. And lambda is proportional to V. Lambda is proportional to V. And therefore, lambda will be proportional to T raised to the power minus 5 by 2. That's the answer. And then that frequency. Well, frequency is proportional to square root of T divided by V. And V is proportional to T raised to the power minus 5 by 2. So F is proportional to square root of T divided by T raised to the power minus 5 upon 2, which means that frequency is proportional to T raised to the power 3. That's the answer part. So these are the answers for this question, right? These are the answers for ABC parts. It was a very straightforward, simple question, specifically for JE Main. Right. I will come with some more problems based on collision frequency and mean free path in my next videos. Till then, you just remember these relations, that what is the expression of mean free path, what is the expression of collision frequency, and how they are dependent on thermodynamic parameters like pressure, volume, temperature in various thermodynamic processes. All you need to know these concepts. Right? So take care, stay at home, and we will meet again in new video with a new problem, with a new concept. Bye bye.